Students, now first year second book standard questions. Again, I am going to give 50 questions. You take paper and pen, check your ability. Under these questions, you have to try the solutions also. First, you practice, then solutions also you learn. First question: Young's margin of the material is y. What is the stress required to stretch a wire to make the length of the wire doubled? The wire is stretched to double its length. What is the stress required? Young's modulus of the wire is y. Answer should be in terms of Young's modulus. A wire suspended, its density is d, without adding load. What is the maximum length suspended is L. What is breaking stress formula? Stress required to break the wire is called breaking stress. The formula for breaking stress in terms of maximum length of the wire suspended, and D is density of the material, and G is acceleration due to gravity. So next, elongation of the wire due to its own weight. What is formula for elongation of the wire due to its own weight? In terms of L, length of the wire, and density of the material D, and Young's modulus Y. Fourth one, what is the thermal force required? Thermal force developed in a rod. Rod is fixed between two rigid supports and temperature is raised by delta theta. What is the thermal stress developed? Fifth one, capillary tube of radius R immersed in a liquid. The liquid rises to a height h, then surface tension formula. Theta is angle of contact and d is density of the liquid. Surface tension in terms of capillary rise. A wire just floating on surface of water. T is surface tension, d is density of the material of the wire. The maximum radius of the wire to just float. The maximum radius of the wire to just float on surface of liquid. Seventh one, a bubble of radius R1 is inside another bubble of radius R2. There is a single bubble of radius R. If the excess pressure in the single bubble is equal to pressure difference between inside the small bubble and outside the big bubble, then the relation between R, R1, R2. Two liquid drops are merged into a single drop. P is atmospheric pressure, T is surface tension. Delta V is change in surface volume of the change in volume, and delta S change in surface areas. Before and after change in volume and change in surface areas. Then what is the relation between them? Pressure P, then surface tension T, change in volume delta V, change in surface area delta S. What is the relation between them? Two liquid drops of radius R1, R2 merged into a single drop of radius R3. P0 is atmospheric pressure. Then expression for surface tension in terms of P0, R1, R2, R3. Next, a liquid drop is moving with a terminal velocity Vt in a liquid of coefficient of viscosity eta. Then viscous force acting on the drop, viscous force formula in terms of radius, coefficient of viscosity and terminal velocity. What is the rate of flow in a Poiseuille's equation? Rate of flow formula in terms of pressure of the liquid is P, radius of the capillary tube is R, length of the capillary tube is L. Next, number 12, what is the expression for Bernoulli's principle in terms of pressure P, velocity of the liquid is V, and height of the flow is H, density is rho. Bernoulli's principle. There is a beaker of cross section area A, and height of liquid is H, and there is a orifice, that means hole near to the bottom. The time taken to empty the vessel, expression for time taken to become the vessel empty. And the 14th one, what is expression for terminal velocity In terms of radius of the drop is r, rho is density of the drop, sigma is density of the liquid, eta is coefficient of viscosity. Number 16, what is the common temperature in centigrade and Fahrenheit scale? What is common temperature in centigrade and Fahrenheit scale? And 17th one, the thermometer which measures distant objects, that is temperature of the sun and stars, what is the name of thermometer? And 18th one, a gas thermometer working expansion of the gas with the rise of temperature at constant pressure. What is the relation between initial volume, final volume, temperature relation? Initial volume at 0 degree centigrade and final volume Vt and temperature, alpha is coefficient of volume expansion of the gas. What is the relation between them? Next, number 19, a pendulum shows correct time at temperature theta 1 and using at temperature of theta 2. Then the pendulum is made of metal of coefficient of linear expansion alpha. What is the loss of time per day? Number 20, two rods having lengths L1, L2 at zero temperature, their coefficient of linear expansions alpha 1 and alpha 2. The difference in their length is E. In order to have the same difference at all temperatures, what is the condition? Next, a scale is correct at theta 1 and using at temperature theta 2. Then, what is the relation between correct length and measured length? If suppose error in the measurement is something, then correct length, measured length and error relation. Next, a sphere is immersed in a liquid because of a pressure volume decreases. To get its original volume, the rise in temperature of the sphere. P is pressure of the liquid, K is bulk modulus, gamma is coefficient of volume expansion of the sphere. What is the relation between density at 0 degree centigrade and density at T degree centigrade for a solid? Gamma is a coefficient of volume expansion of solid. Okay, and gamma R is the coefficient of real expansion, and it depends on nature of material. You know, a liquid is taken in first vessel. In that vessel, coefficient of apparent expansion is A and coefficient of linear expansion is C, and the same liquid is taken in another vessel, the coefficient of apparent expansion is beta. Coefficient of linear expansion you have to calculate. A is the coefficient of apparent expansion of the liquid in first vessel, B is the coefficient of apparent expansion in second vessel, C is the coefficient of linear expansion of first vessel, what is the coefficient of linear expansion of the second vessel? Expression in terms of A, B and C. Next, 25th one, what is the relation between coefficient of apparent expansion and coefficient of real expansion? Coefficient of apparent expansion and coefficient of real expansion relation. Next, 26th one, what is the principle of calorimetry? Principle of calorimetry. 27th one, hot water, cool water are mixed of different masses m1 m2, what is the resultant temperature? And 28th one, suppose you temperature of the body raised by delta theta, S is specific heat, mass of the body is M. What is the heat energy required to raise the temperature of the body? 29th one, two liquids of different materials are mixed. What is the resultant temperature of the mixture? In terms of M1, M2 are the masses, S1, S2 are the specific heats, theta 1, theta 2 are the initial temperatures. Next, number 30th, what is Stefan-Boltzmann's law formula? Stefan-Boltzmann's law. 31, Newton's law of cooling expression, d theta by dt, loss of fall of temperature is equal to expression for that. Next, in the steady state, rate of flow constant, rate of flow formula. 33, what is Wien's displacement law? Expression in terms of absolute temperature and energy, wavelength related to maximum energy radiation. 34th, what is work done in adiabatic process formula? Two formulas are there, at least one formula you have to tell. 35, What is efficiency of the heat engine? If T1, T2 are the temperatures of the source and the sink. What is coefficient of performance of refrigerator, 36th one, in terms of T1, T2. T1 is the temperature of the source, T2 is the temperature of the sink. 37th one, two liquids are mixed. For mixer gas, what is gamma value in terms of if CP1, CP2 are the specific heats at the constant pressure of first and second gas, and CP1, CP2 are the specific heats at constant volumes. Okay, next 38th, what is pressure of the gas in terms of density and RMS velocity, and what is expression for kinetic energy of a gas molecule in terms of Boltzmann's constant and temperature, and mean free path expression, the average distance between two collisions is called mean free path expression for that. Next 41, capital T is time period of oscillation from mean position particle is moving, in how much time the displacement of the particle is half of amplitude, and a particle is in SHM at a displacement y1, velocity is v1, at a displacement y2, velocity is v2 for the particle, then angular velocity of the oscillating particle expression. 43, a pendulum of infinity length is oscillating on the surface of earth, what is expression for that and what is value of that. 44, two pendulums having time periods t1 t2, the bobs are in same phase initially, after how much time again they will be in the same phase, expression for, suppose t time is the time for which the bobs are in the same phase, the relation between t1 t2. 45, a spring pendulum is oscillating, what is the time period of spring pendulum in terms of spring constant and mass of the mass attached to the bob is m. 46th one, frequency of vibrating string is n. Now the string is stretched to double its length, what is its new frequency? 47th one, open pipe has fundamental frequency n1, closed pipe has fundamental frequency n2. They both of them added to make a single closed pipe, what is the new fundamental frequency in terms of n1 and n2? A source crossing the stationary observer, the change in apparent frequency is delta n and original frequency n, and velocity of the source is vs, velocity of the sound is v, then expression for delta n, change in apparent frequency. During beats, what is the frequency of sound? N1, N2 are the frequencies of the sounds. And the last one, source and observer are approaching with velocities v0 and vs, then what is the apparent frequency received by the observer? Expression. Expression for apparent frequency received. Okay, 50 questions finished. Now write down, check your answers and correct it. The stress, first one, stress required to double the Young's, to double the length of the wire is Young's modulus. Breaking stress is equal to LDG formula. L is maximum wire of the length, maximum length of the wire suspended without breaking. Elongation due to own weight, E, is equal to L² dg/2y. And thermal force formula, YA alpha delta theta. And capillary rise surface tension formula, T is equal to HR dg/2 cos theta. Sixth one, the maximum radius of the wire suspended without immersion in the liquid is root of 2T/πdg. Root of 2T/πdg. And a bubble is inside another bubble. In that case, the radius of single bubble R is equal to R1 plus R2. Eighth one, two liquid drops are merged. The relation between pressure, as surface tension, change in volume, change in surface area. 3P delta V plus 4T delta S is 0. 3P delta V plus 4T delta S is equal to 0. And two liquid drops of radius R1, R2 measured into a single drop. The radius of the big drop is R3. Then surface tension is P0/4 into R3 cube minus R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square plus R2 square minus R2 square. R1 square plus R2 square minus R2 square denominator. Coefficient of viscous force formula, F is equal to 6 pi eta RVT. And rate of flow in a capillary tube, Poiseuille's equation, pi P R power 4 by 8 eta L. Bernoulli's principle, P plus half rho V square plus rho G H is a constant. The time taken the liquid becomes flows out from the vessel is small a by capital A into root of 2H by G. Small a is area of the orifice. And terminal velocity of the liquid drop is 2 by 9 R square into rho minus sigma by eta into G. Rho minus sigma into G by eta. Common temperature in centigrade scale and Fahrenheit scale is minus 40 degrees centigrade. The thermometer used to measure the temperature distant objects after, temperatures of distant objects is pyrometer. Gas thermometers working on the principle of expansion of gas, the relation between them Vt is equal to V0 into 1 plus alpha T. From that we can calculate T. And pendulum loss of time per day is half alpha theta to minus theta 1 into 86,400. 20th one, the condition in order to have same difference in length is L1 alpha 1 is equal to L2 alpha 2. And 21, correct length is equal to, if theta 2 greater than theta 1, correct length is equal to measure length plus error. 22, rise in temperature to get its original volume P by K gamma. 23, density temperature relation, D0 is equal to DT into 1 plus gamma T. And in first vessel, coefficient of apparent expansion is A, second vessel, coefficient of apparent expansion is B, then coefficient of linear expansion of the second vessel, alpha is equal to A plus 3C minus B by 3. 25, gamma R, gamma A relation, gamma R is equal to gamma A plus 3 alpha. 26th one, principle of calorimeter is heat lost is equal to heat gain. 27th one, hot water, cold water are mixed, resultant temperature M1 theta 1 plus M2 theta 2 by M1 plus M2. The heat required to raise the temperature of the body, Q is equal to MS d theta. 29th one, two liquids are mixed, the resultant temperature M1 S1 theta 1 plus M2 S2 theta 2 by M1 S1 plus M2 S2. 30th one, Stefan's law, E is equal to sigma into T power 4 minus T naught power 4. 31st one, Newton's law of cooling, d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 minus theta 0. 32nd one, rate of, temperature, the steady state, rate of flow constant, q by t constant, k a theta 1 minus theta 2 by l is a constant. Rate of flow of heat is constant, k a theta 1 minus theta 2 by l is a constant. Wien's displacement law, lambda m into capital T is a constant. Lambda m is a wavelength related to maximum energy radiation. The work done in adiabatic process is 1 by gamma minus 1 into P1 V1 minus P2 V2 or other second one R by gamma minus 1 into T1 minus T2. Efficiency of the heat engine 1 minus T2 by T1. Work by heat extracted W by Q1. Coefficient of performance beta is equal to T2 by T1 minus T2. T2 by T1 minus T2. Or Q2 by Q1 minus Q2. And two gases are mixed, resultant gas gamma is N1 CP1 plus N2 CP2 by N1 CV1 plus N2 CV2. And the kinetic pressure of the gas in terms of density of the gas is P is equal to 1 by 3 rho V bar square. V bar is RMS velocity. 39th one, kinetic energy of the gas molecule 3 by 2 kBT. And mean free path lambda is equal to 1 by root 2 pi n square d or d square n. 1 by root 2 pi d square n, I think. D square n. D is the diameter of the molecule and n is the number of molecules per unit volume. So free mean path lambda is equal to 1 by root 2 pi d square n. and t is the time period of oscillation, the time taken to move from mean position to half of amplitude position is t by 12, and angular frequency of the oscillating particle omega is equal to root of v1 square minus v2 square by y2 square minus y1 square. y1, y2 displacements, v1, v2 are velocities. 43. Time period of pendulum of infinite length 2 by root of r by g. After t time, if the two bobs are in same phase again, then t into 1 by capital T1 minus 1 by capital 2 is equal to 1. 45th one, time period of spring pendulum t is equal to 2 by root of m by k. 46th one, a wire initial fundamental frequency n, now the wire is stretched to double its length. The new frequency n dash is n by root 2. Open pipe and closed pipe are joined, the new fundamental frequency n1 n2 by 2 n2 plus n1. 48th one, the change in apparent frequency delta n is equal to 2 n vs by v. 49th one, during the beats the frequency of sound is n1 plus n2 by 2. And 50th one, the apparent frequency when source and observer are approaching n dash is equal to n into v plus v0 by v minus vs. Okay, so 50 questions answered, check it, and any doubts you call. Okay, my number is 9986898161. You practice the derivation.